Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Sana and today we're going to talk about two simple things. It's air pressure and surface tension. Look at this empty ball. Is this empty ball actually empty? No, it isn't. It has air and it has molecules. Molecules, we know what molecules are. Everything is made out of molecules. The chair I'm sitting on, we are made out of molecules. And also air is made out of molecules. And also in this ball, there's molecules and air. What happens if I pour water in this bottle? The water will take the space of the air and the air will go rushing out. Now let's do a simple experiment to find out if I'm right. Look at this ball filled with juice. What do you think will happen if I take off the lid and I pour it down like this? Yes, you're right. It's going to fall. And what happens if I poke a hole here? The juice in here is also going to fall. Now let's do a simple experiment to find out. Now let's go ahead and poke a hole in this bottle. Look, I poked a hole, but no juice is coming out. Look, there's two holes in it, but the water's still not falling. Let's see and open this lid and see if it's gonna fall. So look, the water is leaking. Why is it leaking? Just if it's open, if the lid is open, then it's leaking. But if the lid is closed, why is it not leaking? Why if I opened that bottle, the water was going out? And why if I closed the bottle, the water was not going out? That is because when I open the bottle, the air sneaks in and it takes the water's place and the water goes out. But when the lid is closed, the air cannot come in and take the water's place. But there's two holes that the air cannot go in. Why can the air not go in those two holes? Because the molecules are really close to each other. They're forming like a very light skin that air cannot escape. Near this hole, there are some water molecules. And these water molecules, they're really close to each other and they form a thick skin. And then the air, it cannot go into the hole. And that's what we call surface tension. So if you open the lid, the air can sneak in and then the water is going out because of the air taking its spot. So what happens if instead of a small hole, I poke a big hole that's like almost like the size of the penny? You're right. The air can sneak in and the water flows out. That's because the surface tension of the water cannot hold it anymore back. Bye, guys. I hope you learned most about air pressure and surface tension. I'll do another video, and also go back to YouTube and watch my other science videos too.